nation against British colonial rule. They failed to pass the cricket test of the Guardian readers of the day. The liberal chatterati gathered around the Bloomsbury group. That's what they were known as. Fabians, liberals, quote-unquote socialists, all clucked and clucked in the magazines of the Bloomsbury group that they could never support this uprising of Celtic obscurantism. Any Ireland that would come from this uprising would be priest-ridden, bog-trotting, a kind of foggy brigadoon, and they could never support it. But the Irish people did not require a certificate of authenticity from liberals in England. The only certificate the Irish revolutionaries needed was from the Irish people themselves. Ireland has largely overthrown imperial rule, though, as James Connolly predicted, if you merely run down the British flag on Dublin Castle and run up a green flag and nothing else changes, nothing much will change. And it's true that one of Ireland's four green fields remains in bondage. But you struck the first blow at the British Empire. And until all these empires fall, the world will never be at peace. Thank you very much.